Hello friends, I am NKJan from Skill on Tech. Today I will discuss and explain about M&Y factor in gaskets. All industries have kilometers of pipeline and thousands of flange joints in their industry and require flange joints shall be leak free to have continuous operation. In the gaskets, M&Y factor is very important. So what is M&Y factor? Let us know by this presentation. Gasket, leak arrestor in flange joints. Can we think that a flange joint can be a leak proof without gasket? Yes. If it were possible to have perfectly mated flanges, and if it were possible to maintain an intimate contact of these perfectly mated flanges throughout the extremes of operating conditions, a gasket would not be required. If the flange faces are lapped, they don't have any imperfections, then certainly the flange joint will be a leak proof without gasket. Imperfection of flange surfaces. As we discussed, flanges always have some imperfections. Flanges have surface imperfections due to handling, erosion and corrosion. They cause leakage in flange joints and require gasket to install in bolted flange joint. The surface finish of flanges shall be AH per ANSI 16.5. You can see a picture of flange faces where surface scorings are visible. So these surface scorings which are visible and occur during handling or due to erosion and corrosion. Therefore, a gasket is required in the mating surfaces to prevent leakage. Selection of gasket by manufacturer. The gasket is selected for a flange joint is a responsibility of a manufacturer. Choice of the gasket type is the obligation of the end user. The vessel manufacturers design the flanges and bolting to sufficiently seal the joint against leak. You can see a picture of a flange joint where a gasket is provided and bolts are provided to make the perfect flange joint. Bolt loads. Stresses for installation of bolt load is shown in a sketch. A sketch is shown where you can see what may be the maximum permissible bolt load and what is zero bolt load and what are the stresses required to overcome flange imperfections, a seating stress on the gasket plus a torque value or a bolt load against the internal fluid pressure plus buffer against joint leakage, losses due to creep of gasket or variation due to inaccuracy of bolt loading techniques. The operational bolt load shall be minimum seating stress plus minimum operating stress. The final stresses on bolt or studs require above stresses plus losses due to creep in gasket and bolt tightening variations plus buffer against damage of flange, bolt or gasket. We know that we must have a zero leakage flange joint. So here you can see this is a zero bolt load. There is no torque value on the bolt or no zero stress on the bolt. But this is a bolt load to achieve minimum seating stress. This line which is shown. So a minimum seating stress is required on the gasket, that is most probably 2 psi against the imperfection of the flange surfaces. And this is a bolt load to achieve minimum operating stresses. So there is always an internal pressure in the system. So this is a minimum operating stress on the bolt to make a leak proof joint. But there are always thermal loading on the joints, so this is a buffer zone. So this is a operational bolt load, final operational bolt load, or a torque value on the stud. But you can also see there are losses due to internal pressure and external loading, and losses due to creep, typically gasket creep. So this zone is given to overcome all these problems. So this is a bolt load to achieve target gasket stress. So this is a installation bolt load, this one. Thereafter, because there are always inaccuracies in bolt loading technique, and we also need a small buffer against damage of the flange, bolt or gasket. So this is the maximum permissible bolt load or a torque value or stresses in the struts or bolts which is required to make a sound flange joint, which will have a long life and will give you a zero leakage and best performance of the flange joint. M and Y factors of gasket. Gasket should be able to create a static seal between two stationary members of a mechanical assembly. Maintain that seal under operating conditions, which may vary dependent upon changes in pressure and temperatures. Conform to flange surface and compress enough to seal any voids or spaces. The design of bolted flanges require the gasket constants referred to as M and Y be used in the calculation when determining the right gasket for a flange joint, where M represents the maintenance factor. This and Y represent the seating stress. Gasket manufacturers use M and Y values, gasket stress and load, to ensure the designer is using the correct gasket material and thickness. M factor. You can see a picture of a flange joint where a bolt is shown and a gasket is shown in the flange joint. You can see here, this is a flange bolt load. This bolt is tightened in a flange joint and this gasket is provided here. So there is a hydrostatic end force. This is acting in this direction to make the flange faces apart. And this is a internal pressure. This acts against gasket directly. The M factor allows the flange designer to determine the compressive load on the gasket required to maintain a seal when the vessel is pressurized. The flange must have sufficient strength and bolting to hold the joint together against the hydrostatic end force, which is shown in the picture, and to apply some additional net stress on the gasket. To determine the M factor, gasket manufacturers divide the net stress by the internal pressure to create the dimensionless M value as follows. So here you can see M factor equal to W minus F hydrostatic force upon AG into P, where W is a bolt load in pounds, F HYD hydrostatic end force, AG gasket contact area inch square, and P is the internal pressure of the system. Y factor. You can see a picture of a flange face where a raised face OD is shown, and this is gasket face is shown, and this is a gasket area. The Y factor is calculated by using the following equation. Y factor equal to W upon Ag, where W equal to bolt load in PSI. This Ag equal to gasket contact area inch square. The Y factor is the minimum compressive stress and is not meant to be a seating stress value for actual service. The Y value compresses the voids of the gasket and conforms the gasket to the flange surface. Reference M and Y factor for spiral mount gasket. There is currently no industry standards test to determine the M and Y gasket constants. Many gasket manufacturers have developed individual test procedures based on the ASTM F586 test method. There is no approved ASME alternative to the code that requires use of these constants. The FSA Gasket Technical Committee is developing a test procedure to fill this void. Until an alternative design method evolves, and as long as M and Y are used, a test standard will be needed to ensure consistency in the reported values of these constants for gasket materials. However, for a reference, we have shown a spiral mount metal non-asbestos filled. This is a type of gasket design, and gasket material is stainless steel or monel metal. Gasket factor M is 3. Minimum design seating stress Y is in PSI, 10,000 PSI. So, for different gasket materials, there will be a different gasket factors and seating stresses Y. So, you can see that in the tables which are given in the books. Thanks for watching the video. If you like this video, hit like button below. Share it with your friends and colleagues. Subscribe our channel for getting updates on upcoming videos. Please leave any comments, feedback to improve the videos. Thank you.